Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and WWDC 2022 is something we've been anticipating for a very long time. Apple announced it the other day, and so I wanted to go over all the details of when to expect it, what you can do as far as watching it, also when to expect iOS 16 and 16 betas as well, along with everything else we should see there. Now, this is my favorite event of the year, and it was announced the other day, like I said. WWDC 2022 was finally given a date of June 6th to June 10th. This is typically a multiple-day event where developers have the chance to sort of talk to Apple internally, their engineers, learn more about the next versions of the operating system, and just maybe help perfect their code or maybe optimize it a little bit, ask questions and more. So this is very helpful for developers, and it will be a virtual event again. You can see here, this is Apple's website. It says WWDC 2022, and it says call to code. Join developers worldwide from June 6th to 10th for an inspiring week of technology and community. Get a look at Apple's latest platforms and technologies and sessions, explore the newest tools and tips, and connect with Apple experts in labs and digital lounges, all online and at no cost. In addition to the online conference, Apple will host a special day for developers and students at Apple Park on June 6th to watch the keynote and State of the Union videos together, along with the online community. Space is limited, and details on how to apply to attend will be provided soon. Wherever you watch from, get ready for a fantastic WWDC. So it's not going to be in person this year, but they are going to allow some people to show up and watch virtually. Again, we don't know how that's going to work, and no invites have been sent out. So Apple did not send out invites to individuals this time around like they do usually. Instead, it was a press release, and then they updated their website with it. So that's something that's a little bit different this time around. Maybe they'll send some invites, but at this point, watching it virtually is going to be the same as being there in person as far as the overall what we're going to see, but being there in person would be great as well. But maybe next year we'll actually see that. Now, again, like I said, it will be online only, and you'll be able to watch it on June 6th. June 6th, though, they haven't said specifically when you're going to be able to watch the keynote where they introduce the next version of all their operating systems and maybe some more surprises. So it says June 6th, and typically that's at 10 a.m. Pacific time or 1 p.m. Eastern time. However, this could change since they haven't said specifically. Now, as far as what this symbol means, typically it represents something about the OS or something they're doing. Maybe it means a redesign. We don't really know, but that's the little Swift icon there for programming. So not really sure what that means just yet. We'll probably figure out why it's a little bit more symbolic as to what it's going to represent with the next versions of iOS. Also, they're having the student challenge again. The Swift student challenge, you'll see here if we go to that website, it says, we continue our long-standing support of students around the world who love to code with this year's exciting Swift Student Challenge. Showcase your passion for coding by creating an incredible Swift Playgrounds app project on the topic of your choice. Winners will receive exclusive WWDC 2022 outerwear, a customized pin set, and 1 year of membership in the Apple Developer Program. So that's something they've been doing every year, and then you can apply for that. And you have to be 13 years of age or older and then register, and then you can win that different merchandise or different things. So that's great to see they're doing that every year. And if you're interested, be sure to apply. Now, also, if you're going to follow along with WWDC and you're not already familiar with this, well, it just popped up, you'll want to go into the Apple Developer app. You can install this for free and then sign up. And all of the information you need and all of the different sessions from WWDC will be here. So if you go to WWDC, they'll have all of your different sessions, and you can see some of them from the past, from last year. It says platform, State of the Unions. There's all sorts of keynotes and different things to help you if you're learning to code, or maybe you're already coding and just need some more information. So that's great to see them update this every year. And of course, this will be updated as we get closer to WWDC and then after, of course, as well. Now, as far as what to expect, well, we do expect iOS 16. iOS 16 will be the next version of iOS, and I think it's going to see some major changes. We haven't heard very much at all as far as rumors and things like that. We haven't heard from any very reliable sources of what's going to be in it just yet. And so we can expect iOS 16 to be shown, along with iPadOS 16, watchOS 9, HomePod and tvOS 16, macOS 13, and maybe even a few surprises. There's a possibility of Reality OS, which we've seen in the code, which represents what we think is going to be in the VR and AR headset that haven't been announced yet. So all of those things are expected. And on the first day of WWDC, Apple typically releases betas after the keynote. So after that 10 a.m. or 1 p.m. Eastern time keynote, usually a couple hours later, as that's a long keynote, we'll see the release of the first iOS 16 betas. So we'll have iOS 16 beta 1, iPadOS 16 beta 1, and so on. All of those betas released to developers the first day, a couple hours after the first keynote or within an hour or so. And then also we'll see the public beta usually a couple weeks after that. So if you want to wait for the public beta, typically it's 2 to 3 weeks after the initial beta when we get closer to iOS 16 beta 2. Then we see that initial release to the public beta testers, and then we'll have all of the betas along with iOS 15 betas all the way until September. So that's typically what Apple does. And then when they announce the next event in September, where they show off the next iPhone, so we usually will see iPhone 14 and watchOS Series 8, at that date, usually we'll get a time frame of when to expect iOS 16's release to the public, usually within the second or third week in September. So that's normally how Apple does things year over year, and that's what we can expect. Now, we can also expect possibly some hardware announcements at WWDC as well. Sometimes they have that, sometimes they don't. But based on what Apple had with the March event, they said we'd get a glimpse of the Mac Pro later on. So they mentioned Mac Studio, of course, with the Mac Studio display, and then they said Mac Pro, and they said we'll leave that for another time. So based off of that, we should see Mac Pro hopefully at WWDC, which would complete the transition to their own silicon. So that makes a lot of sense that we would see it and maybe have a release later in the year, as well as maybe some new iPads. We haven't seen iPad Pro this year. Maybe we'll have that along with this new fifth generation iPad Air. So we're waiting for all of those things to be released soon. And again, you can go to WWDC on this website and check out all of the things here. I can't wait for it to be updated. Now, as far as what to expect with iOS 16, well, like I said, we haven't heard a lot of information from reliable sources. So last year, many of us thought we'd have a new control center with additional things such as maybe some changes to widgets. This year, I'm hoping for interactive widgets, maybe an updated control center, as well as a few other small changes here and there where maybe we could rearrange our icons. My main thing that I want is a redesign of the icons. It's been a very long time. We haven't seen a whole lot about this, and it looks like maybe we could get some redesign based off what we're seeing with WWDC's icon. So hopefully we'll see some sort of redesign, but since people have been working at home, it's hard to say if they actually were able to fully redesign iOS 16. And I know quite a few people wouldn't be really interested in that, but some people would love that. But interactive widgets, maybe a new control center, updated Apple Music would be something I would love to see. Quite a few people complain about the overall interface just being sort of messy and kind of difficult to navigate compared to what Apple typically does. So I would love to see a redesign of at least a few different apps and some icons as well. Let me know what you're looking most forward to with WWDC in the comments below. And of course, I'll have coverage of all of the different versions once they're released and what Apple announced at WWDC as well. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.